Good morning students, now we continue the second chapter, that is PLC fundamentals. Now the new point, memory organization in PLC. The PLC memory is divided into two types, that is program memory and data memory. The memory is also called as a file, that is program file and data file. Okay. Now first we see program files or program memory. Program files is divided into four types. System function, memory location is 0 or file 0. Reserve, memory location file 1. User program, memory location or file 2. Subroutine programs, memory location 3 to 255. That is file 0, file 1, file 2, file 3 to 255. Now first we see the system functions, that is file 0. This file or memory contains the system related information and user program information. For example, processor type, IO configuration, processor file name and password, etc. Now, second memory. Reserve, that is file 1. This file or memory is reserved by the processor. It is not accessible to the user. Third, user program or main program, this is called a file 2. This file or memory always includes and contains a user main program, that is a main program. Program stored in a file 2, main program stored in a file 2. Subroutine programs, that is file number 3 to 255. This file or memory are user created and activated according to the subroutine instructions. That is subprograms are stored in a file number 3 to 255. Now, data memory or data file. Data file is divided as output image, that is file 0, input image, that is file 1, status, file 2, bit, file 3, timer, file 4, counter, file 5, control, file 6, integer, file 7, reserve, file 8, network, file 9. This is a system defined. Now, this is a user defined, that is bit, timer, counter, control and integer. This is memory location from file 10 to 255. Now we'll see one by one. Output image, that is file 0. This file or memory stores the status of output terminal of a controller. Input image or file 1. This file or memory stores the status of the input terminal of a controller. Status, that is file 0. This file or memory stores the control status and controller operation function. This is useful for troubleshooting of a controller. Bit, file 3. This file or memory is used to store the internal relay logic status. Internal relay logic status. That is relay on or off. Or is a single bit on or off. This is timer, a third timer. Timer, file 4. This file or memory is used to store the timer accumulated value, present value and the status. In next lecture, we will deeply see how to enter the timer value in accumulator, how to see the present value and the status of a timer. This the timer file 4. Counter. This file or memory stores the counter status and counter data. Control. File 6. This file or memory is used to store the control element status and the data. It is used to control various files and instructions. Integer. File 7 or memory location 7. This file or memory stores the integer value. The stored integer values are displayed in a decimal. The integer element in a single word, that is a 16-bit element. Reserve, file number 8 or memory location 8. This file or memory is reserved for processor data. Network, file number 9 or memory location 9. This file or memory is used to store the network status and the data. Now, user defined, memory location 10 to 255, that is file number 10 to 255. These files or memory are user defined. A data may be related to bit, timer, counter, control signals, etc. This is the memory location of PLC. Now we will see the I/O module selection criteria. I/O modules. Which are the I/O modules? I/O modules. These are the I/O modules. Input-output modules. That is AC input module, DC input discrete module, DC input analog module, AC output module, DC output discrete module, DC output analog module, and some special I/O modules. Okay, that is communication modules. Communication modules are ASCII I/O module, RS-232 interface module, high speed encoder input module, resistance temperature detector as RTD input module, stepper motor control module, thermocouple or millivolt input module. These are the some input output modules. Now the selection criteria of input output module. Now input output module selection criteria. Discrete input input module. These module is selected when type of input signal is AC or DC, two step on or off, or open or closed signals. These module selected when hardware input devices are push buttons, switches, motors, stepper motor, level switches, two step pressure or temperature sensors, etc. Means for that purpose we have to use the discrete input module. Now second, discrete output module. This module is selected when type of output signal is AC or DC, two step on or off, open or closed signal. This module is selected when hardware output devices are alarm, light, motor, solenoid valves, fan relays, slew tails valve, etc. For that purpose we have to use the discrete output module. Now analog input module. This module is selected when input signal is analog input voltage or current. This module is selected when input devices are temperature, pressure, humidity sensor or flow sensors, transducers, analog switches, potentiometers, etc. For that purpose we have to use analog input module. Now analog output module. This module is selected when the output signal is analog voltage or current. This module is selected when output devices are analog valves or meters or stepper control devices, etc. Now, discrete 5V TTL input module. This module is selected for 5V DC TTL input signal from microprocessor or microcontroller. Suppose we have to give the input from microprocessor to the PLC, then we have to use the discrete 5V DC TTL input module. Second, discrete 5V DC TTL output module. This module is selected for 5V DC TTL output signal from microprocessor and microcontroller devices. Suppose we have to give the output to the microprocessor or microcontroller, then we have to use the 5V DC TTL output module. From PLC to microprocessor or for the microcontroller. Application specific modules or specific function or special function modules. These are different application specific modules or special function modules like communication, high speed counter, motion control, stepper motor control, etc. These are used depends upon the requirement of equipment. Okay. Now it's end of the second chapter. Thank you.